Psalm 37 verse 23. The Bible says in Psalm 37 verse 23 that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord and he delights in his way. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord and he delights in his way. Father, bless the reading of your word as we get ready to pray. Now, when the Bible talks of a good man, it means a man who has the right intentions. When the Bible talks of a good man, a good woman, it means you are a king's daughter who has the right intention. So as we come to commit the year to the Lord, then you have to have the right intentions. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 6, you know, sometimes you can commit something to the Lord, but you don't have the right intentions, okay? You don't have the right motive. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 6, the Bible says that blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. For they shall be filled. The Bible says, blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. When we hunger for righteousness, when we hunger for God, he comes and fills us with his righteousness. You see, the righteousness you have is not of your own. It is God who fills you because you hunger. You come to him to get saved, and then he fills you with his righteousness. And then when you hunger for righteousness, then, you know, a lot of things begin to happen because God comes in and he begins also to melt your weaknesses and to do everything that you need him to do in your life. And so you have to have a desire, you know, to continue hungering for God's righteousness in your life. Not just, you don't just get saved, but you continue, you know, to desire, you know, to hunger for the righteousness of God. And the Bible says that when you do hunger for his righteousness, then he comes and fills you, and then he counts that as righteousness. So I pray that this year, every king's daughter will be a woman who will hunger for God's righteousness in your life, that you'll hunger for him this year as we begin 2017. And the Bible says that there's none that is perfect, okay? You're not perfect, you know? You are a good woman because, a good man because you are hungering for the righteousness of God. You're wanting God to use you. You're wanting God to deal with your life. You're wanting God to be able to help you to live the Christian life. The Bible says in Romans chapter 3 verse 10, there is none that is righteous, no, not one. Okay, the Bible also says in Matthew chapter 19 verse 17, there is none that is good but one, and that is God. And then the Bible says in Romans 3:23 that we all come short of the glory of God. So what is being said is that it is only God who is righteous. He's the only one who is perfect. But the Bible says when you hunger and thirst for righteousness, he will come and fill you with his righteousness. Are we together? And then he counts it as righteousness, okay? So king's daughter, a good man, a good woman is not only saved, but a person who wants God to be able to lead and guide them. You want to allow God to lead and guide you in your life. So I pray that this year you will allow God to lead you and guide you. You know, that is what we need to begin with this year, to allow God to lead and guide us. In every decision we are going to make in our walk with him, we want him to lead and guide us so that our steps will be ordered by him. Your steps will only be ordered by God if you hunger for him. And if you want him this year, king's daughter, to lead and guide you, I can tell you that he will lead and guide you. And this is a word for somebody. So king's daughters, let us hunger for God this year. Hunger for growth in our relationship with God. You know, hunger for spiritual growth. What are your plans, you know, to grow spiritually? Do you have a plan this year to grow spiritually? Are you pursuing a time, you know, to just have some Bible study? Maybe get a devotional, another devotional book that will take you deeper into the things of God. Do you have any plan this year to grow spiritually? Because we want to commit our plans to God. But do you have any plan as a king's daughter to grow spiritually as you hunger for God and you ask him to fill you with your righteousness? Do you have any plan of how you're going to grow spiritually? If you don't have a Bible study group, you can join a Bible study group. You know, you can join to Jengane class. You know, you can desire, you know, to grow spiritually by making a plan of how you want to do it. And then when you plan, then God will come and help you and lead you and guide you. And so we want to commit our year to the Lord as we hunger for Him, you know, so that as we commit our plans to Him, they will succeed, because we are hungering for Him. We want Him to be the one to lead and guide us. And so we want to have the right intentions this year as we commit our ways and plans to God, that He will lead and guide us. And so as we talk about committing our plans to God in 2017, it is important to note that, and I was telling this to the congregation the other Sunday when I was announcing about the King's Daughters, if you are committing your plans to God, it is so important to note that you yourself, as a person, you must be a committed person. You cannot commit something to the Lord if you yourself, you are not a committed person. And as I mentioned that, my prayer is that this year, we will be committed to the King's Daughters ministry, especially those of us who are House of Grace members, that you will be committed to the King's Daughters ministry. And for those who are visiting with us for the first time, I want to thank God for you, because you have come to hear the word of God. You are committed to growing, and so keep on coming. I want to thank God for you. So we need to be committed this year, you know, to the King's Daughters ministry. If you're a King's Daughter ministry of, if you're a King's Daughter member of this church, my prayer is for you that you will be committed to the King's Daughters ministry, committed to praying for the King's Daughters ministry, committed to coming to the meetings and supporting them. And I know that as you do, God will also now bless the way you are living. He will bless you as you come. You will receive a word that will take you to another level. Somebody said, I will be committed. Amen. You know, be committed this year to whatever you are committing to God. Be committed to whatever you are committing. You cannot just commit something to the Lord like, you know, your calling, your ministry, your children, your marriage. If you are not committed to your marriage, if you're not committed to your children, how you're going to teach them, how you're going to grow with them, you know, you cannot just say, sometimes we just come and say, oh God, I commit my children to you, I commit my marriage to you, but you yourself, you're not really committed. You have to be committed to make that marriage work. You have to be committed to mentor your children. You have to be committed in whatever you are doing. If you're going to commit it to the Lord, then you need to know, King Zora, today, that you yourself, you have to be a committed person, you know, and then be committed to authentic relationships this year. This year is the year of authentic relationships, especially for the single ladies. Don't be committed to anybody who is not willing to be committed to you. If that man is not being willing to be committed to you, don't be committed to him. Don't waste your time. Don't be committed to anyone who is not willing to commit, you know, himself to you. Don't be committed to anybody who is not going to be committed to you this year. Because you see what? You don't need everybody, you know, around you. You don't need everybody around you this year, because sometimes you are weakened, you know, by the people you ally in your life. Sometimes the people who come into your life, they weaken you. Don't be committed to anybody who is not genuine. Don't be committed to anybody who is not authentic this year. And that is especially not only is for the single ladies, but even to those of us, you know, who are not single, you know, don't commit your time to anybody who is not committed to you. Only invest your time, you know, to people who are committed to you. And I know I'm speaking to some people today. Don't waste your time, you know, don't waste your time, you know, with anybody who is not committed to you. Don't waste your time with anybody who is not committed to you. You cannot give your time to someone who is not committed to you. And that is for us this year, that we will only be committed to those who are willing to be committed to us. Now, that was my introduction. And having said that, I want to first pray that this year, like I said, we will hunger for God. We will hunger for God. We will hunger for righteousness. We will hunger for God more than we even did in the year 2016. We will read the Bible more than we did in the year 2016. Have a plan how you're going to read the Bible. Have a plan, you know, if you're not serving, have a plan how you're going to serve God, you know. Be committed, you know. Be committed to what you want to do. Have a plan with what you want to do. And the plan that we have this year, we want to begin the year with hungering for God, you know, wanting to know, how am I going to grow spiritually, you know? If you don't hunger for God, then your life is not going to move to another level as a child of God. You know what? Christians are no longer even reading the Bible. Many a times Christians are just on Facebook, I don't know what. I know people are going to go and all those kind of things. But you don't want to know what God is saying. So let it be that this year, you will hunger to read the Word of God more, to know more about the Word of God than what people are doing, more about the Word of God than what people are doing. Sometimes I'm in the office and I'm saying, I don't know where so-and-so is in our school, but they're back in town. You didn't see it on the Facebook? And I said, hey, me, I don't look. And I said, we thank God, you know, for technology, but you know what somebody is eating or something like that. You know what they are eating. You know, let us pray that this year we will hunger for God and that we will grow in our relationship with God. And that's what we want to pray, that God will help us to be able to put time to read the Word of God, to pray and ask Him to fill you with His righteousness. Why are you laughing, you know? Because I'm always being told, so-and-so, what not? Did you know so-and-so is in hospital? I said, why? You didn't see on the Facebook. I'm like, okay, why didn't they call the church office, you know? So we want to just go on the Facebook. We don't want, you know, I want this year to be a year when you will be putting messages on the Facebook. You say, God gave me this word today, you know, God has healed me today, you know, God is able to heal you. Let us change this thing of technology, that we will be people who are putting things, or even if you're going to say that I'm back in town, it's okay, but say, God preserved me, you know, He protected me at least, and then give us scripture and say, I'm back in town, I thank God because He preserved me. But most people just want to show off sometimes, you know, but when you put it, I want to see any king's daughter this year, when I see you saying you are somewhere, put a scripture. You know, put a scripture and say, God has provided for me. Yes, God has provided for my children, you know. But most of the Facebook, and I'm sure you know what I'm talking about, people just want to show off, but they don't want to thank God for what God has done. So let this be a year where we are going to hunger for God, you know, do evangelism. We are going to hunger, you know. We want to read the Bible more this year, and we want to ask Him to fill us with His righteousness. And when you hunger for God, then He also begins to melt things in your life, the weakness, is that because He fills you with His righteousness, so things begin to leave you. You know, have you noticed that sometimes when you have grown as a Christian, there are some things you used to do that you no longer want to do because God has removed, He's melted those weaknesses. So we want to commit this year to the Lord, to hunger for Him, to read the Bible more, to plan how we are going to do it. And anything that you want to commit to the Lord this year, first of all, I want us to hunger, you know, for righteousness, to hunger for God, to hunger to grow in our relationship with God. So let's just rise up on our feet, because the other thing I want to tell you, just rise up on your feet. We want to commit, you know, our lives to God. And what I want us to also do, and this is very important, as you stand, as we pray to hunger, you know, for God this year, that God will give us the grace, you know, to even read the Bible and so on. It is a time to rededicate, you know, your life to God. Rededicate your Christian life to God. Rededicate yourself to God. Ask God to cleanse you and to sanctify you as you begin the year 2017. That's how you want to begin, that we can ask God anything that maybe you did in the other year, as you come across over, Lord, cleanse me, sanctify me, and just tell God, I have not been the Christian that I should be, but Lord, I rededicate my life to you that you may come and fill me with your righteousness. Come on, let's begin to pray as we dedicate our lives to God. Personal lives we want to dedicate to the Lord. Let's begin to pray and dedicate our lives to God and hunger for God. Ask God to help us to hunger for Him. Father, we want to thank you, Lord, for we have rededicated our lives to you, and want to thank you, Lord, that Father, Lord, you have sanctified us and you have cleansed us with your precious blood this morning, oh God. And that Father, as we hunger for you, we want to thank you, Lord, that you will fill every king's daughter with your righteousness, oh God, this year, that we will be able to walk in your victory in the mighty name of Jesus. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. So now we have rededicated our lives to God. We need all the time to come to God, to rededicate our lives, to ask Him to cleanse us and to wash us. So now we are ready to commit our ways to the Lord. We are ready to commit our ways to the Lord. We want to commit our ways to the Lord. And this means that if you're going to commit anything to the Lord, you have to have a plan. You can't commit something to the Lord if you don't have a plan, if you don't have a strategy. You have to have a plan. Okay, when the Bible says commit your ways, it means that you must have a plan. You must have a strategy. You can't just come and commit something to the Lord which you haven't planned. What plans you have? It is referring to the plans that you have. When the Bible says, commit your ways, it means you have planned something. You have to have a plan that this is how I want to do it. But then that plan, you commit it to the Lord. Don't just commit things to the Lord just the way we do. I commit my children this. Just have a plan. You have to have a plan and a strategy so that now you give that plan to the Lord. You give that strategy to the Lord. And everyone should have a strategy. A strategy, you know how you want to fulfill your dreams in 2017. You have a strategy and a plan for your business. You have a strategy for your ministry. You have a strategy for your children, for your anything that you want in your life to be done. You think it's very important in your life. You must have a plan. And I'm sure many of you didn't come with a plan this morning, but you know that's why you came. As we pray, you will have to say, God, this is how I want to do it. Don't just say, I commit my daughter, I commit my son. What plans you have for that child? What plans you have for your ministry? What plans you have for your business? Commit to the Lord and he will lead you and guide you. And then, you know, you want to pray for him to direct your path as you commit that plan to him. And then the Bible says he will order your steps. So what plans do you have? God wants you to be very specific about what you want to see in the life of your children, in your ministry, in your calling. God wants you to have a plan so that when you bring the plan, then he will direct and order your steps. Do you have a plan of how you're going to spend time, you know, with your spouse, you know, to strengthen and get deeper into the relationship that you have with your spouse? Do you have a plan how you're going to bring up your children this year? Or what you're going, do you have a plan how you're going to deal with that rebellious child? Do you have a plan? So when you bring that plan, you tell God, this is my plan, Lord. I want you to lead and direct me. So begin to think of the plan that you want to have this year, the strategy that you have, because that's why we are here, to bring those strategies and those plans to God. Do you have a plan how you're going to exercise and stay healthy this year? How you're going to limit on your eating? It is not an easy strategy, but do you have a plan? You can't do something, even plan to diet, if you don't have a plan. Anything you want to do, you have to have a plan and a strategy and then bring it to God. So when we want to get ready to pray, you have to have a plan and a strategy of how you want to do that and how you want to accomplish that, because God has given you the ability to plan. He has given you, you know, a brain to think. So you have to have a strategy and a plan and bring that plan to the Lord. Plan for the most important things in your life. So now we want to commit those strategies that we have. If you didn't come with a strategy, as you kneel down, just begin to think, how am I going to deal with this? Plan and say, I'm going to plan this. God, help me with this. Lead me and guide me. So let's rise up on our feet, or you can sit down, or you can kneel down, whichever, however way you want to pray, however way you are comfortable. If you want to go on your knees, let's begin to pray and commit those strategies that we have to the Lord. Every time you commit something to the Lord, your business, he becomes the chairman of your board. Then he helps you in your decision making. When you dedicate and commit your children to the Lord, you have a strategy. Then he will help you to lead and help guide those children. Let's begin to pray and commit our plans to the Lord. Let's rise up on our feet and begin to pray. Thank you, Lord. He will lead and guide you. As you commit your plans to him, he will lead and guide you. Put your hands together and thank God, because he is the one who is going to lead us, because we have committed our plans to him. It doesn't matter what you go through, but because you're going to be his faithful follower, he will lead and guide you. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. It's such a powerful meeting. I'm just thanking God that you came here just to pray, because many prayer meetings are not well attended. But we want to thank God for every one of you that has come to pray, because God, as you have come today to commit your ways to him, he will lead and guide you this year, because you're a faithful follower. So now we want to pray for the wisdom of God as we pursue our plans. I know many of you have plans and strategies, like we have said. Now we want to just ask God to give us wisdom. You know, you can have plans and strategies, but you don't have the wisdom. And in James chapter 1, verse 5, the Bible says, if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to all liberally and without reproach, and it will be given to him. You need wisdom. Wisdom is to know how to go about it. So the plans that you have, you need the wisdom from God. And he says, if you ask him for wisdom, he says, said he will give you liberally. So ask God to give you wisdom. You know, we want to ask him to give us wisdom for the plans and the strategies that we have. You can have plans, but you don't have the wisdom to know how you go about it. Now, let me explain something about wisdom. Wisdom is not the same as knowledge. Knowledge is to know what to do, but wisdom is to know how to go about it, when to do it and how to do it, when to speak, when to start even that business. You need wisdom. You know, you need wisdom. You know, you need wisdom when you're dealing with your spouse. You need wisdom when you're dealing with your children. You need wisdom. So every plan that you have, every strategy that you have, you need wisdom to know when and how to do it. You know, for example, an educated person can know what to say, but if they don't know how, when to say it and how to say it, where to say it, you know, you find that you just mess yourself up completely and it will cost you a lot. So anytime you don't have wisdom, you don't operate in the wisdom of God, you will mess yourself up. So we want to ask God to give us wisdom. That's why we came. We have the plans, you know, we have the plans, we have the strategy, and now we want to ask God to give us the wisdom, wisdom to know what to do. And so we want to just rise up for the next 2-3 minutes. We just want to ask God to give you the wisdom. You have given him the plans, you have committed the plans to him, but ask him to give you wisdom when to start it, how to go about it, to know when to speak, when not to speak. Ask God to give you wisdom. Let's rise up on our feet. Receive the wisdom in Jesus' name, because you have prayed in Jesus' name. The wisdom he has already given you, because he said when you ask, he will give you, and he has given you. Appreciate him for the wisdom that he's giving you for your plans. In Jesus' name, you may be seated. Okay, we want to pray for the prayer item. We want to pray for God to send us the right people our way. Destiny, help us. You can have the plans, you can have everything, and he'll give you wisdom, but now you want to pray for God to send the right people your way, people who'll be your destiny helpers, who'll help you to fulfill your destiny in the name of Jesus, to fulfill your dreams and the strategies that you have. You know, God doesn't use animals, he uses people. So ask for God to send you destiny helpers to fulfill your dreams. Now in Mark chapter 2, verse 1 to 5, is the story of the man who was sick. He had palsy, and then 4 friends brought him through the ceiling, because in the house where Jesus was, it was crowded. They couldn't go through the door. So 4 friends brought him through the ceiling to bring him down so that Jesus Christ could heal him. These were 4 friends that brought him, you know, destiny helpers that brought him. They brought him. This man was sick in bed, and he needed people to carry him to where he would get his miracle. So we want to pray for God to bring you destiny helpers, people who will get you to your destiny, who will help you, people God will have sent your way, not the devil. So you could be in one place, okay, and you could be there, and your miracle is there. You need a destiny helper. Maybe you're not able to even get there. You need God to send you somebody to help you to get there. So we want to pray for God to send us destiny helpers. You know, people will help us to fulfill even the plans that we have, the dreams that we want to achieve this year. So we want to pray for the right people to come our way to fulfill our assignment. And as you pray for destiny helpers, also, you have to pray away people who will come to spoil, you know, your good year. You want to pray away anybody the enemy will want to bring to spoil your good year. You know, pray for the people you're going to have coffee with this year. Pray for the people you're going to give lift. You know, you can even give somebody a lift from church, and then they can be talking funny things and just spoil your good year. You know what I mean? So pray for the people even you'll have coffee with, the people who you'll give lift to. You just pray away. And even as church members, we want to pray away any demonic agents that the enemy may want to bring this year into the church. I'm not saying we pray away people who have weaknesses or whatnot, who have issues, because the church is a hospital. I'm asking that we pray away demonic agents this year who would want to come to the church. And if you're from another congregation, pray for your church that God would keep away demonic agents, because many of times we don't realize that the devil also has his own plans. But we want to pray away any demonic agents, anybody that the any assignment, anybody who has an assignment by the enemy to come and bring your life down, you want to pray them away in Jesus' name. So we want to rise up and begin to pray. Okay, for God to send us destiny helpers. God to send somebody to help you to get to where you're going. You know, a destiny helper, somebody will help you to get to your miracle. Just ask God, please, God, send somebody my way in the name of Jesus who will help me. Because, you know, you need other people, okay? You need people. You cannot do things alone, you know, here on earth. You need other people to help you. So let's begin to pray for God to send us destiny helpers. In Jesus' name we declare victory in the name of Jesus. We nullify every plan of the enemy in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let's rise up on our feet. We now want to have our last point. We just want to pray for strength. We have prayed for wisdom. We have prayed, you know, for God to send us the right people. We have prayed and committed everything to the Lord that He will lead and guide us. We have prayed for wisdom. And now we want to thank God. We want to accomplish. We want to pray for strength to accomplish everything. You need the strength of God. In Isaiah 40:31, the Bible says, "But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength." You know, when Jesus was going to die, He needed strength to fulfill what God had asked Him to do. And how about us? We also need strength to be able to fulfill what God has given us to do. You need the strength of God in whatever plans that you have. You need the strength of God. And when you tell God to give you His strength, He will infuse strength, you know, in your life. When you come against challenges, He will infuse strength. Ask Him to give you strength this year for every challenge, for anything that you have committed to Him, that He will give you strength. So we want to just tell God, give me your strength in the name of Jesus. And the Bible says in Philippians 4:13 that I can do all things in Christ who strengthens you. Okay, He strengthens you. Hallelujah, Lord. I want to thank you for giving me the strength, Lord, this year to lead the King's Daughters ministry. Oh God, I thank you, Father, and I bless you in Jesus' name. Somebody appreciate the Lord because He's giving us the strength to be able to do that which He has called us to do. And then finally, we want to give God thanks and praise in advance, you know, for the success of every plan that we have given to Him. We want to thank Him in advance because He's going to do it. Many people want to give God thanks when it has been done, but we want to give God thanks by faith in advance for the plans that we have, that there's going to be success, there's going to be victory. We want to thank Him for the wisdom that He's giving us. We want to thank Him, you know, for the provision. We want to thank Him for what He's going to do in advance. So open up your mouth and just thank God for what He's going to do. In the name of Jesus, because we have prayed, and He says, when we pray, He answers our prayers in the name of Jesus. Amen. So we just want to tell God we are so grateful for all that He will do for us, because He will do it in Jesus' name. As we sing this song, we're not going to say, "Oh Lord, I'm very, very grateful for what You've done for me," because He has done already so much for us. But by faith, whatever you have prayed, we are going to be very grateful that He's going to do it for us in Jesus' name. Amen. Oh,